So check it. Have y'all seen that new show by The Rock? The Titan Games. Listen, I don't really watch a whole lot of TV, but the other day I walked in and Mike was watching it and I saw these two women going at it. I was like, okay. The best part about watching was the end, because at the end I found out that both of them are moms. First question, how in the world did you get rid of that baby weight and tighten up like you did? Second question, when exactly did you start training to be a Titan? I would say you started training to be a Titan the winter after your first child was born. I love the fact that the competitors on that show are regular people. Today's lesson, how moms train to be Titans every day. Listen, it starts with squats. I promise you, between the ages of 0 and 2, you are going to drop more things than you have dropped in your entire life. No lie, your squat game is gonna be strong. Like for real, quads, tight as a mug. You dropping passies, you dropping bibs, you dropping food, and then you double squatting for food because you're trying to pick it up before anything happens to it. Everything just seems to get dropped. Then you're doing deadlifts, because I don't know about you, but my toddler weighs 32 pounds. There's going to be a constant routine of having to pick your kid up. Oh, come here. Ready? Here we go. But we can't forget about them arms though. Any nighttime routine that lasts more than 90 seconds usually requires some great arm situations. And you know, if your kid has thrown a tantrum in a public space or a parking lot, you getting all of this worked out right here. Just all of this. Wanna know why? Cause you one arm in that joker. Get up. Off the ground, you trying to get hit by a car. But that's not the highlight. The highlight is the final challenge, that Titan game that gets you the crown, the dreaded walk to the car in the winter. First of all, we're only making one trip. How, you say? So you get the keys, you put them in your pocket, halfway though, so that you'll have accessibility later. You get the diaper bag on one shoulder, your work bag on the other shoulder. Now grab your coffee, then it's the test of picking up the child. Make sure that you're balancing well to squat down, okay? Pick the kid up underneath the armpit, on the hip. Inevitably, you will realize that while you were wrestling to get your child's coat on, you put your phone on the arm of the couch. You got to reach, not reach, reach and get it. Underneath, get down, grab your phone. You ready to go out the door. Doors open, you walk out, pull them keys out, gotta lock the door back, keep the kid in your arm. So you're going down the driveway, sidewalk, whatever your situation is, and the inevitable is going to happen. What? What's gonna happen? You know, that child will begin to slide down your hip. I don't know why kids just can't stay in place when you're moving. And until your kid is about 20 months, you're not getting any help. They don't know how to squeeze them legs together to help stay on your hip. You go have to do all the work. Everything's in place, kid's sliding. What do? You take that right leg and that hip, get enough air for the kid to just settle right back down in place. You got it. And don't let me forget, the passy's coming out. Oh, something's falling. So now you've got to make the ultimate squat with everything in your arms without dropping it. I don't know what it is, but something inside of me just gets enough strength to do it just the one time. If it were to fall again, which it usually doesn't happen, but if it were to fall again, I think I would cry. So you're pressing all the way to the car. Click, click, van doors slide open. You deliver the baby into a heated vehicle. What? You did it. You're a Titan. What? All the moms and dads out there, people picking up babies, trying to get them to daycare and school and whatnot. I wish we could celebrate mom and dad Titans every day, because them jokers, they be putting in work. So keep going. Don't give up. Don't quit. You're killing it. If nobody told you that, you're killing it today. Until tomorrow, remember, I know absolutely nothing.